So once we've installed our DNA server and our management console, as we see here, the final step of the process is to discover the devices across our network and deploy our agent technology onto each of them for ongoing management. And how do we do that? Well, there are three approaches that we can take. The first and simplest is to visit each device or PC in turn with the NetSupport DNA agent setup file on a memory stick and manually install the product onto each and every PC. Slightly time consuming, so the second and more practical approach is to use the NetSupport DNA discovery and deployment tool that's provided as standard within the product. Selecting our tools menu from the menu here, you see discovery and deploy is presented and available to us from the menu here. Once we open the discovery and deployment utility, we can see at the top of the dialog we have three options: discovering PCs based on an IP address or range, discovering devices by using Windows networking, or finally by identifying machines via Active Directory. So let's have a look at all three options. Via IP address, we can simply select the Add button and enter an IP range of computers on the network. So let's select the range 10.0.0.1 through to 128 and say OK. And you'll see instantly we create a list for each IP address within that range. And NetSupport DNA in background will be scanning and identifying machines on the network that are suitable for installation. Where a DNA agent is already installed, that will be reported and shown within the view. So that's our first option, simply discovering the machines over the network via their IP address. The second option is to move to our Windows networking tab, and by selecting Add, the system will allow us to now discover based on all the available Windows networking or Windows workgroups that are available. In this case, we have a long list here. Let's select UK and instantly be presented with a list of devices within that membership. If we select OK, they're now added to the system. In this case here, you'll see not only do we have the machine name, department, IP address, and DNS name, but we also have the MAC address, platform. If they have a DNA agent installed, we can see the current version of the agent. We can see what driver is used, if any, for managing our internet control within DNA, and finally details of the manufacturer for each device. Finally, via Active Directory, we have a similar option. Again, we can select Add, and from Active Directory, we can discover and select any AD groups, in this case, the UK group. And once again, we're presented with exactly the same option to select either all or members within that domain. When we say OK, they're then presented for us again within our view. So each of these approaches allows us to discover the devices across our network as presented using either their Windows networking details, our Active Directory groups, or specific IP address ranges. Once we've found a particular PC or PCs, we can select all or individual PCs. In this case, let's select a couple. And you'll see we have the option to both deploy our technology and, where appropriate, to remotely uninstall our technology. Selecting Deploy allows us to present a dialog ready to begin our installation. If we select our Options tab, we can identify and specify the address of the server. Because we're running the deploy from within our current console, the current server address is provided automatically within the dialog. We can choose if we want to enable our internet restrictions driver as part of the installation, and we can also choose whether we want to have the product displayed within our add or remove programs entry. And finally, if the deployment fails, we can specify a number of retries as well as a time delay between each of those attempts. Once we're happy, we can simply select start, and NetSupport DNA would automatically deploy the agent to each of the selected devices. The NetSupport DNA discovery and deployment tool can be used across a number of Windows platforms, from Windows XP 2003, Vista, Server 2008, Windows 7, Windows 8 and 8.1, Windows Server 2012 and Windows 10. However, due to operating system limitations, the Discover and Deployment utility will not work with Windows XP Home, Windows Vista Home Premium or Windows 7 Starter or Home Editions. Okay, so that's our agent technology deployed on each PC and device that we've discovered across our network today. Of course, in reality, there will be other devices that are currently off-site or will be acquired and added new to our enterprise in the weeks ahead. So as well as our discovery and deploy component, NetSupport DNA also provides the ability to constantly monitor the network and present details of any new devices that are discovered automatically. Those discovered devices can then be selected by a console operator, and if deemed appropriate, a DNA agent can then be deployed onto those for future management. Any new devices that are discovered are displayed within the Discovered tab at the top of our hierarchy view. Selecting Discovered provides us with a list of devices within any of the different groups that we can see, and then where appropriate, we can deploy our technology. In this case, there are a number of unknown devices that we can choose to monitor and manage accordingly. So how do we go about identifying these devices in the first instance, and then subsequently pushing our technology? Well, let's go to our Settings tab. And you'll see we have a feature, Auto Discovery, which is currently enabled. If we select the Auto Discovery tab, you'll see very simply we need to enable the feature and specify range or ranges of IP addresses that we wish to scan on a repeat basis to identify any new devices that are added to the network. In this example here, we've entered a scan range of 10.0.0.1 through to 10.0.0.128 by entering in the boxes below and selecting Add. And we've provided credentials for a network administrator that has administrative rights to discover and investigate each PC on the network. Once that's enabled, the system will constantly poll, and where appropriate, new devices will be identified as they are here. A very limited inventory of information is provided about each machine, providing us with the option to decide if the machine is appropriate for us to subsequently deploy a DNA agent onto. As you'll see, right-clicking on any selected PC gives me two options. One, deploy an agent, and the second, to ignore that machine and not to continue reflecting it within my view. As simple as that. If we select a PC and select deploy to, as we saw before, we can identify the PC in a familiar deploy dialog, and if appropriate, now we see the information, it's Windows Server 2003, we can use our deploy tool to push our technology quickly and easily onto the machine for subsequent management. When we're done, we can hit close. If we return to our PC view, this reflects all devices that we've identified that have a NetSupport DNA agent on. We can then now monitor that machine moving forwards. Thank you for viewing this tour. Please visit www.netsupportdna.com to find out more, or if appropriate, download a free 30-day trial.